So, first look at the divorce decree. We might not have to go back to court to argue about this.
Arthur, a lot of celebrities out there, including Jenny McCarthy and her boyfriend Jim Carrey, think that vaccinations cause things like autism and that sort of stuff. But there's no medical evidence to prove this.
Well, it's really catching on. It was the cover of Time magazine, I believe, 2 weeks ago. And not to make this too personal, but I know my wife is extremely concerned and is constantly researching about vaccinating our son, because although it hasn't been scientifically proven, there are indications that there may be a cause and effect. In all due respect to Jonna, I'd like to just disagree. This could wind up back in court. Even if the mother has legal custody, which means she has the ability to make this decision, if Charlie Sheen thinks she's doing something so egregious that's hurting the welfare of the child, he could go back into court and ask for that decree to be looked at again, the divorce decree, and adjusted so that he does have those powers to make those types of decisions. And in this particular case, could really put up a fight and say, Judge, you make the decision, I'll present my evidence, she'll present hers, and you decide how it should be handled.
Jonna, in the letter that Charlie Sheen's lawyer wrote to the doctor, they had a phone conversation apparently with the doctor, and the doctor's reason for not, I guess, listening to Charlie Sheen's wishes is because he said, quote, I do not turn away sick children.
Exactly.
You're not exactly sick when you go into the doctor for a vaccination.
Well, that's true, but is it fair for Charlie Sheen to be able to terrorize this doctor or any doctor and say, I'm not giving you consent to treat my kids, whether it's a vaccination or strep throat or whatever they're coming to you for, when they have another parent that has custody of the kids who says, please, I'm coming here for you to treat my family. So, you know, you can't put the doctor in the middle of this court battle.
So what's his recourse? He's got, it's a bottom line kind of thing. He doesn't want that shot administered to his child. So where do you go? You go right to the source of the person who's administering the shot and says, hey, I'm putting you on notice. If you do this, you're going to be held responsible.
He's a doctor. He's taken an oath to treat patients that walk into his office. Charlie should have thought about this before he signed on the dotted line when these two got divorced.
But Julie's right. What Julie just said is, when you're coming for a vaccination, you're not sick. You're coming in to prevent being sick.
You could be preventing something that could kill you.
You could be preventing, but it's nothing that's so imminent, that's so necessarily that needs to be done at that particular moment. The Charlie Sheen has no choice. If his wife won't listen to him, then the doctor better and a judge better get involved to make this decision.
No way.
Well, there are a lot of parents out there that really do fear that autism, perhaps the chicken pox vaccine, could also possibly cause negative side effects. Until we know for sure, I could see where Charlie Sheen has the right as a father to make decisions about his kids. But Arthur Aidala, thank you very much. And Jonna, thank you both.